Android or iOS? Which one to learn? Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and I want you to hit that subscribe button because in this video we are going to dive deeper into this topic. Now let's be clear about one thing. This video is not about a debate of which one is better, Android or iOS. You can do that down below in the comments if you wish, but this video is about what you have to consider when you want to either switch from Android to iOS, from iOS to Android, or you want to upgrade your development knowledge from either one of those. So let's just take a look at the first one that I really want to share with you is that hardware. Now, if you are an iOS developer, you already know that you can develop iOS and Android apps on your Mac. You can just download Xcode or Android Studio on a Mac environment. But if you are an Android developer and you have Windows, you know that you cannot run Xcode on your Windows PC because Xcode is a Mac OS application only. So you have to either have a virtual machine on your Windows or you have to rent a Mac in the cloud. I already have a video on that, on how you can run Xcode on Windows. So go ahead and take a look at that too. It's in the playlist. Okay, so one thing you have to consider is the hardware, whether you want to buy it or whether you already have it. Okay, now let's move on to the second issue here is that licensing. How much basically does it cost to develop or rather yet to license out all of the tools that you are going to use building Android or iOS apps? And the first one here is Android. That is $25 and it is for a lifetime. Now you have to just pay this only once and you will have an Android developer account for a lifetime. Now for iOS, that is a little bit more expensive and that is $99 per year. It used to be long ago that you had $99 per year for iOS development and $99 per year for Mac OS development, but they just wrapped it all together for $99 per year for all Apple related development. So that's a good thing, but I still think that $25 per lifetime is really low entry point. So there are a lot of, let's say, not that well made apps on Google Play Store because of this, and you have to consider all of this because entering the App Store is much harder because there is a review process that is much more stricter than on the Google Play Store. So yeah, keep in mind that you have to obey much more rules than on the Play Store. Okay, next up is IDE. Which app do you use to build out these apps? And for Android is, of course, Android Studio. There are a lot of helpers there too. And if you'd like, I don't know, maybe Atom, you could do that too. But that's the default, and you can just download it on your Windows computer, and it's also available for the Mac. Now for iOS, you have to have Xcode installed, and for that, of course, you have to have a Mac or some Mac alternative that I talked in the other previous video. Now this could be a deal breaker because you can only develop iOS apps on a Mac environment. Okay, and you have to have some sort of I don't know, a prepayment or something code like that, because you have to have a Mac environment. Okay, by the way, Xcode is renowned to be really buggy, and it still is, I admit it, but it can be do wonders for your app. It's really fast, and they keep on upgrading it, improving it. Not on all fields, but it's really good. Android Studio has come a long way. It was rubbish, but now it's really nice to work with. Okay, let's move on onto the fourth tip I want to share with you today, and that is the code, the language that you are going to build these apps out with. And for Android, that is Java. That is a really kind of robust language that you have to learn or you have to get accustomed to. On the other side, Swift is a brand new, well, not brand new, but it's in a few years in, and it's really, really easy to pick up, easy to improve on. It is much, much faster to get accustomed to Swift than with Java. So that is my two cents. I really love Swift. And of course, if you are wondering, what about Objective-C? Well, you could learn Objective-C for iOS, but that is for older apps. And the tendency is that new apps or brand new apps are built with Swift only. Okay, let's move on to our final slide here, and that is the user base. Now, what do I mean by user base? Well, when you want to decide what kind of developer you want to be or you want to be to, like from Android to Android, iOS, and you want to think about the monetary consequences. Now, for that, maybe you want to build your own app, and you want to know what the user base is. Maybe you want to have some in-app purchases. Maybe you want to have some ads. So for Android, there is a large, very large user base, but they are kind of on the cheap side. So they are not, and they are not quite purchasing in-app purchases. But on the flip side, they want free stuff. They do accommodate to free stuff, so they are more likely to tap on ads inside your app. So you need to take a look at that. On the other side, on iOS, there's a small population, maybe in your country, but basically if you are targeting the US, you are kind of lost without any marketing. So think of the iOS user base as quite small that you could reach easily, but they are much wealthier there and they tend to buy more in-app purchases. And of course, there's a lot of the larger pool that does not buy in-app purchases, but also taps on ads. Now, if you are you want to build out your app, that is what you want to take a look at. But if you want to basically get hired, then it's kind of the same. iOS developers tend to be paid a little bit more because it's a closed ecosystem. It's kind of a more specialized type of work. But Android apps, the whole project tends to be much, much more expensive. So the company gets more money per app that they build. So maybe they just move that money down to you as the developer. So you need to take a look at all of these monetary consequences when you choose your development. Okay, that is it. So now you know the ups and downs, the pros and cons about iOS and Android development. Now I want you to hit that notification bell because in my next video, I will be talking about iOS app development companies. Yeah, that's right. Go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Hit that like because that's an awesome topic. In the meantime, make sure to check out these videos as well too. I talk a lot about iOS development in general, SwiftUI, Swift, and of course, as usual, I will see you in the next one.